Dear students, this is S. Pandey of Springer Public School going to teach you the subject Commercial Studies. Now, this lecture is for class 9th Commerce. Students, we are very much disturbed with this corona, deadly coronavirus. So, my request is that you keep yourself safe. Yours and your family members, and in this way the society as a whole. Now students, we have to keep on moving and doing our duties. So let us begin with the first chapter, human activities. Now students, in ISCSC Commercial Studies for class 9C, this subject contains two sections. One is commercial studies, means related to commerce, and second one is related to accounts. Now this chapter relates to commerce, and the name of the chapter is human activities. Now first of all, we should go through the contents of this chapter, and the chapter contents are its meaning, types, its various types, means economic activities, non-economic activities, these are the two main types, and then the comparison between these two activities, distinction between business, profession and employment. Now students, first of all you must know about this human activities. It is very simple. Human activities means all those activities which are performed by we, the human beings, and we all have to perform some economic or non-economic activities. It is undertaken to satisfy our unending wants, and these wants can be classified, these needs can be classified into basic needs, social needs, safety needs, esteem needs, and self-actualization needs. So just to satisfy all these needs, we have to perform some activities, and those activities are called human activities, and that may relate to economic activity or non-economic activities. Now students, main characteristics or features of human activities. It involves human efforts. We have to do something to earn our livelihood. Jeene ke liye kuch karna padta hai. So we have to perform just to survive, grow and make money and create wealth. Human efforts required. Continuous throughout life. It means it continues throughout the human life from the very birth till death of the human beings. Now, a person cannot live without doing the activities for even a second. Lord Krishna preached in Bhagavad Gita that we, the human beings, cannot remain idle for even a single second. Either we do some economic or non-economic, some routine activities, some social activities, but we do perform some of the activities. Now the third one is human activity involve wide range. Wide range means thousands of activities are there, and but the all the activities can be classified in two activities, economic and non-economic. In economic, business, profession and employment. In non-economic, social, religious, patriotic, all these activities. But if we count down the activities, it is more than 1,000. Now let us move to the next point, performed both for earning and obtaining personal satisfaction, that I have already explained, that we perform economic activities for earning some income and wealth, and non-economic activities for personal satisfaction. Now students, there are two main types of human activities, economic and non-economic. And now let us proceed to the economic activities. First of all, you should know what is economic activities and why it is necessary. So economic activities are those activities which everyone is required to perform to satisfy his wants and to earn his living. Now to earn his livelihood and to satisfy his wants. Economic activity is a must for all of us. Without that, we cannot survive. Now, let us move to the features of economic activities, and it has several features. First one is economic motive, means that economic activities are performed to earn some income and to create wealth. Now, productive means it is related to production and distribution of goods and services, and it is meaningful only when the goods are properly produced and distributed to generate revenue. Now, economic resources, land, labor and capital, man, machinery, method, material, all these are the various economic resources which help the business organization for in the production and distribution process, and it is a must for all the business organizations. Now, rational use means proper use, optimum use, and this is very much required for the better utilization of the resources of production, land, labor, capital, man, material, machinery, method, etc. Now, economic growth. The aim of the economic activity is the economic growth of the world, economic growth of the country, and economic growth of the particular individual being. Now, legal and valid. The economic activities must be legal and valid. It must be permitted by the law. It should be legal, justified in the eyes of law. If you earn something through illegal activities like smuggling, robbery, etc., that is not under the definition of economic activities. Now, the next point is socially desirable. The activities must be permitted by the society. If some activities are undesirable, and that should be taken into consideration, and only the activities which are permitted by the society and are desirable in the eyes of the society, that comes under the definition of economic activities. For example, advertisement of adult films, advertisement of cigarettes, alcohols, these are not socially desirable. They are permitted to a certain extent. So these are the various features of economic activities. Now, students, examples of some economic activities like production of goods by a manufacturer, distribution of goods by wholesalers, selling of goods, storage of goods, transportation, legal services, services run by doctors, work of government officers, etc., etc. Now, let us move to the next topic, non-economic activities, and that are undertaken to satisfy the social, religious, cultural and sentiments of the people. Now, these are the activities which are not for monetary gain, but for mental and physical satisfaction. People undertake these non-economic activities due to the following reasons: love and affection. Our mother cooks food due to love and affection, not for earning money. Personal satisfaction. When we help someone, we get internal satisfaction. Physical needs. We do some exercise. We go for meditation. These are the physical needs to keep ourselves fit, and this is also not related generally to money. Religious obligations. We perform some rituals, go to temples, mosques, church and gurudwaras just to perform our rituals. These are the religious things, and our cultural needs, religious needs. These are generally not related to economic activities. Social obligation. We take all the resources from the society, so we are obliged to do something for the society, and this is also not for earning money. And patriotism means we have to donate something, do something for our country. Generally, we donate blood for our army men and some funds in for the charity purposes in the Prime Minister Relief Fund, etc. Now, students, we will again continue in the next lecture. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.